Hello and welcome to the episode 214 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today we'll talk about a 1963 gig in Liverpool, a couple of holidays, and Paul McCartney producing Badfinger, among other things. On the 2nd of August 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed another double feature at the Cavern Club in Liverpool, playing both a lunchtime and an evening concert, supported by Carl Terry and the Cruisers and Dale Roberts and the Jay Walkers for the latter. Roberts offers some insight about what the band was like at the time in the book The Cavern, quoted on BeatlesBible.com. "We had never seen the Beatles before, and we saw these black leather trousers and black jackets and long hair. They got on stage and they blew me away. They were louder than anyone else, but they had the equipment." 2 years later, in 1963, the Beatles returned playing in Liverpool for the first time in 7 weeks, getting on stage at the Grafton Rooms. For the occasion, they were supported by the Undertakers, Sonny Webb and the Cascades, the Coasters and the Denisons. It was the second time the Beatles had performed on the premises, the first being nearly 1 year before, on the 3rd of August 1962, as we will see tomorrow. The arrangement and the £100 fee, about £2,100 in 2020 money, had been negotiated on the previous January, but the Beatles honored the commitment anyway, despite being able to command about 3 times as much money for their performances by now. Brian Epstein, furious for not being able to talk Grafton's promoter Les Arkley out of having the Beatles in his club, decided to get at him by arranging an engagement at the Cavern Club on the following evening. The January contract prohibited the Beatles to play anywhere in Liverpool too close to this evening's concert, but it didn't specify anything about what happened afterwards. In 1964, the Beatles played the Gaumont Cinema in Bournemoth, sharing the bill with Mike Berry, Adrian Poster, and the band described as, and I quote, "a new and unknown London group, the Kings." Ever heard about them? 1965. On this date, NEMS Enterprises announced that the Beatles would not undertake a British tour in 1965. Holiday time in 1966 and 1967 for the Harrisons. In 1966, they left London for a quick break in Devon before the Beatles left England for their final US tour. They spent several days at Patti's mother's 18th century farmhouse in Studlake before returning home. 1 year later, the Harrisons, Neil Aspinall and Alexis Mardas were in Los Angeles. The group went meeting Ravi Shankar at his Kinnara School of Music, watching him teaching Indian music, and later having dinner with him. And I am not asking for a free dinner when I ask you for a donation, but perhaps a free coffee? Please visit www.simonmas.com/support and consider showing me how fab you are, doing something to help me to keep producing the best music-related content I can. Thank you! And now, let's go back to the studio. On the 2nd of August 1968, the Beatles kept working on Hey Jude, completing 3 stereo mixes of the song. The work took place at Trident Studios, where the song had been recorded in the 2 previous days, between 2 p.m. and 1:30 a.m. Let's close the episode with Paul McCartney producing the recording of Badfinger's Come and Get It, a song he had penned and arranged himself for the band, signed to Apple. In episode 205, we saw how Paul had completed the demo of the song before a Beatles session. Badfinger recorded a note-by-note rendition of that demo, just a bit faster, with Tom Evans being chosen by McCartney for the lead vocal performance. Paul sang backing vocals and played tambourine on the track. The song was mixed and issued as a single in December, reaching number 4 in the UK charts. It was also featured as the opening track for Peter Sellers and Ringo Starr's The Magic Christian, also appearing on the closing credits with a different mix. This ends my efforts today. Tomorrow we have the Beatles' final performance at the Cavern Club. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.